Hello everyone. So far we have studied the Cauchy's theorem for triangle, rectangle and circular disc, and almost the first unit is done. So as I already told you, you have total 4 units, that is unit 1, unit 2, unit 3 and unit 4. So total 8 questions will be there. So from each unit you will be getting 2 questions. Fine. But I'm assuring you that in certain years what they have done is, for example, in unit 1, 2 questions should be asked. So one question will be like question A, question sub questions. One question is divided into 3 sub questions, among which first 2 sub questions are asked from first unit, whereas third question is asked from the second unit. If you want, I have forwarded the question papers as well as syllabus copy. You can go through that. Fine, so there may be a chances to merge the questions from the units. So you cannot choose in this topic, it's up to you. Anyhow, I'll do all the units. Syllabus is very vast, especially complex analysis. And one more thing is that whatever I have done in the first unit, if you want, you can go through the syllabus copy. So I have done maximum, I mean, I completed the first unit almost. But the thing is that when you look at the question paper, there is certain concepts called Mobius transformation. Mobius transformation, and they have asked one of the theorem related to this Mobius transformation, as well as conformal mapping with reference to what we say cross ratio. Fine. So these two concepts were asked in the question paper, but these two syllabus are not there in the question paper. I'm sorry, not there in the syllabus copy, but it was asked in the question paper. And moreover, these topics will not be doing in any of the university, either in BNU or in BU. So they are not doing this concept. Anyhow, I'll just try to complete these topics also as per my knowledge. So I'll send you the notes and I'll explain maximum concept, but I'm not going to do it in detail. Because this concept is very vast. If you go for further studies like PhD, you will come to know the concepts in detail. But anyhow, I'll try to complete the questions, only the questions which they have asked in the university. And I'm requesting you that please don't share this, especially these two questions, with your friends. Fine. So it is important questions, and moreover, it will be repeating questions, but it is not in the your syllabus copy, but it was asked in the question paper. So I have collected this concept, and let me explain with my best of my knowledge. So first question is that this is the last concept of first unit. So if this session completes the first unit completely, so you're left with 3 more lessons. I'll do it anyhow. So concept is exactly, I don't remember the year, hope so it is 2015 or 2017. Define Mobius transformation. And also prove that Mobius transformation maps, I'll just write here, define Mobius transformation, and also prove that Mobius transformation maps circles and straight lines in the Z plane, Z in the sense complex plane, in the complex plane into circle or straight line. If you go through the question paper, you can clearly see this question. So define Mobius transformation, and we have to prove that Mobius transformation maps circles and straight line in the Z plane into circles or straight line. The concept is that Mobius transformation, in the sense, suppose if you are considering any 4 points like A, B, C, D in a complex plane such that they are constant, and moreover AD minus BC, when you're going to take product on the difference, it will not be equal to 0, then the function W or S of Z, so this is a representation for Mobius transformation. Fine. So the function W or S of Z is equal to AZ plus B divided by CZ plus D. So this function is called as Mobius transformation. I am repeating once again, for any constant ABCD in a complex plane such that AD minus BC is not equal to 0, then the transformation or a function defined by W is equal to S of Z, which is equal to AZ plus B divided by CZ plus D. So function of such kind is called as Mobius transformation. Fine. Sometimes it is also called as bilinear transformation, one and the same. Fine. Now let me explain the next concept, cross ratio. cross ratio in the sense, suppose if any four points is given, like Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4, all four points are in complex plane C. Usually complex plane is represented by C. Fine. Then a cross ratio is of these four points is given by, that is cross ratio of Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4 will be equal to Z1 minus Z3 into Z2 minus Z4 divided by Z2 minus Z3 into Z1 minus Z4. So this is the definition of cross ratio. So if that was the case, we can express a Mobius transformation in terms of cross ratio. So I have given, since it was asked for 6-mark question, that is theorem along with the definition, so I have tried to elaborate the concept in order to cover 6-mark. Fine. So you just first write the Mobius transformation definition. Afterwards, you write the Mobius transformation in terms of cross ratio. That is, we have already defined the Mobius transformation like this. Now we can express the Mobius transformation in terms of cross ratio. In terms of cross ratio. And is given by, Mobius transformation in terms of cross ratio is given by Z2, Z3, Z4 is equal to Z minus Z3 divided by Z minus Z4 is 2, Z2 minus Z3 divided by Z2 minus Z4. Fine. And moreover, all these three points, that is Z2, Z3, Z4, will map to 1, 0, infinity in the complex plane respectively. Anyhow, in depth of this concept will be, you study in your higher studies, that is, there will be a large number of theses on this. Anyhow, you just remember the concept, Mobius transformation in terms of cross ratio can be defined as such. So this is what the concept of Mobius transformation is. Now we have to prove that this Mobius transformation maps circle and straight line into Z plane. This is all three dimensional, I mean it is abstract, you have to imagine the concept. So we have to prove that this transformation maps circles and straight line into circle and line. Fine. So let me write the proof here. So to prove this, let us consider a mapping, Mobius mapping. We are going to consider a Mobius mapping. As I already told you, Mobius mapping is also called as Mobius transformation. It is represented by W or S of Z. So let us consider a transformation as 1 by Z in order to prove this theorem. Where W is U plus IV and Z will be of the form of X plus IY. Fine. And where W is equal to U plus IV, then U can be defined as X by X square plus Y square, and V is given by minus Y divided by X square plus Y square. Or else if you want, you can cross multiply this, or else, I mean, what I'm trying to say is I can write X in terms of U as U divided by U square plus V square. Similarly, Y can be written in terms of V, that is U and V, minus V divided by U square plus V square. We can write this. Fine. So this is the basics of complex plane. Now let S be a circle. S be a circle with radius r and center alpha. Then standard equation of a circle is given by standard equation of circle in its complex form. In its complex form is given by Z minus alpha into Z bar minus alpha bar is equal to R square, where Z bar is conjugate, and you have to remember the properties of complex number. So if Z is a complex number and Z bar is its conjugate, then the product will be equal to magnitude of Z whole square. Anyhow, you have studied this in first PU. Fine. Now let me simplify this, that is multiply these two terms, Z into Z bar minus Z into alpha bar minus alpha into Z bar plus alpha into alpha bar is equal to R square. Now I'm going to shift this to other side. Before shifting, since it is of the form alpha into alpha bar, comparing with this, I can write this as alpha, magnitude of alpha whole square. So this, with this above equation can be written as alpha Z bar is equal to R square minus magnitude of alpha whole square. Now let us substitute the transformation that we have assumed. W is equal to 1 by Z. Meaning is that Z is equal to 1 by W. So if you replace it with this, so if you have Z as 1 by W, implies Z bar will become 1 by W bar. Fine. So you have to replace the same values in the above equation. With this, this equation can be written as Z in the sense 1 by W, right? Z bar in the sense 1 by W bar. So I can write Z is 1 by W, that is alpha bar by W minus alpha by W bar is equal to R square minus magnitude of alpha. I'm sorry, bar is not there, whole square. Now let us take this as equation 1. Fine. Clearly, if there is no point in S go through origin, then resulting image is a circle. So whatever the equation I have obtained, if there is no point go which pass through origin, then this equation 1 represents circle. Fine. Which is passing through radius. I mean, which has the radius which is equal to alpha. Then this equation can be written as 1 minus alpha bar omega minus alpha into omega is equal to 0. Why? Because, I'm sorry, W bar, or you can read it as W also. Not a problem. So, what I did is I have taken LCM here. LCM is W into W bar. You just take LCM and simplify this. You will get back this. See here, W into W bar get cancelled. Here, W into W bar you multiply. WW get cancelled. You will get W bar. Again, W into W bar. W bar, W bar get cancelled. You will get W. Since if a circle is passing through origin, then R value will be, radius will not be there. So, R is equal to unit circle case. So alpha will not be there, R will not be there, so that is why it is equal to 0. And this will be a parametric form of line. Parametric form of line. Fine. So equation 1 represent a circle and equation 2 represent a parametric form of line. Therefore, what can I say? That a transformation f of z is equal to w is equal to 1 by z maps either to a circle or to a line. Hence the proof. So this is not in your syllabus. Anyhow, I have given this. Fine. And one more concept is conformal mapping. Conformal mapping. So this is also not in your syllabus, but they have asked it. So conformal mapping in the sense, a transformation W is equal to F of Z is said to be conformal mapping if it preserves angle between oriented curve. In the sense, if you are going to rotate any curve in a complex plane, then in such a way that angle should not be changed. So if that was the case, we say it is a conformal mapping. I'm repeating once again, if a transformation W is equal to F of Z is said to be conformal if it preserves angle between oriented curves in magnitude as well as in orientation. So it should not be there should not be any change in length as well as its orientation. Whatever the curve you have, whether it is circle or it is parabola or it is ellipse, whatever the curve you are going to take in a complex plane, if you're going to change it, I mean if you're going to rotate it, it should preserve, in the sense what we say, there should not be any change, or it should preserve a magnitude as well as orientation. Then such kind of mapping is called as conformal mapping. And further, if f is analytical, as I already told you, analytic in the sense, if a function is differentiable at a point z and its neighborhood, then f is said to be analytical. So if further f is analytical and f dash of z is not equal to 0, then also f is called as a conformal. Meaning is that it is just an example of conformal mapping. And one more thing is, Mobius transformation is also one of the example for conformal mapping. If a function is not changing, I mean every function represent a curve in a complex plane. Fine, since it is a function of a complex number. So if you differentiate that, and moreover derivative is not equal to 0, meaning is that it preserves its orientation, I mean it preserves angle between orientation of a curve as well as magnitude. So that is an example for a conformal mapping. Fine. And one more theorem which is asked based on conformal mapping, it is important for 6 mark. So here is a theorem which is asked for 6 mark. In the sense, define conformal mapping and hence prove that this theorem is given. So as I said, conformal mapping definition also I will give. First you write the conformal mapping definition and then you just write this proof. And I am telling you repeatedly, please don't share this material with your friends. Fine. Now, since it is 4 points are given in terms of cross ratios. Fine. So we have to prove that these points is real only when these points lies on a circle. Now, to prove this theorem, so first let me take given point as TZ. That is transformation with respect to Z. Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4. Now, to prove this theorem, we have to prove that all these points lies on a circle C. Then, TZ is real. Right? That is what we have to prove. Fine? But, as per the fundamental property of the transformation, just now I have explained, that is Mobius transformation, all the points, here it is, Z2, Z3, Z4, it is a standard form. Z2 is always mapping to 1, Z3 is mapping to 0, and Z4 is mapping to infinity. Fine. Hence, a transformation T is real in its inverse relation. I'm just this concept is very wide, and you can study the in detail in your higher courses. You just remember. So this transformation T maps Z1, Z2, Z3. Whatever I'm explaining, I'm just giving it in a form of definition. Fine. So Z1 is mapping to 0, Z2 is mapping to 1, and Z3 is mapping to infinity. If that was the case, T will be mapping to its inverse. Fine. That is, if Tz is real, then we can write Tz is equal to, inverse is none other than, in terms of complex, it is conjugate. Fine. So I can write, as per the definition of conformal mapping, that it is Aw plus B divided by Cw plus D. Now it is, wherever you have A, you are going to replace it with conjugate. B bar divided by C bar, B bar plus D bar. Now let me cross multiply this so that you will get Aw plus, you can pronounce this as omega, it is better. Why? Because we are dealing with a complex number. Fine. So C bar omega bar plus D bar is equal to C omega D. I am just doing a cross multiplication. Fine. So after, when you are going to multiply, after this step, I am just going to give a same in the notes as well. So if you multiply each and every step, you will get AC bar. You have to practice this, no way. Omega square plus A into D bar minus C into B bar into W. If you multiply these two and apply property, what I said, Z into Z bar is equal to magnitude of Z whole square. You have to apply that property so that when you are going to multiply all this term, it will be elaborating. So I am writing it directly. So you will get this. Plus, you will get this step, plus B C bar minus dA bar. I have just simplified this by taking the common factor. If you want, you can multiply these two terms and apply the property, you will get this, one and the same. Now, as per the definition, as I already told you while explaining, this term should not be equal to 0. That is, product of this value with this value and this value with this should not be equal to 0. So as per the definition, that is, I am just repeating once again, product of this element with this and product of this element with this should not be equal to 0 in Mobius transformation. Similarly, I can write here that A into C bar minus C into A bar. Fine. I am mapping it. A into C bar minus C into A bar. Fine. After mapping, this element should not be equal to 0. Then, if this was the case, this Egbo equation can be written in its standard form as A bar D minus C bar B divided by A bar C minus C bar A, which is equal to AD minus BC divided by A bar C minus C bar A. And moreover, this represents equation of a circle. Fine. Therefore, whatever the transformation we have chosen is a Mobius transformation or a linear transformation, one and the same. Linear transformation or a Mobius transformation is one and the same. Or one more thing is that every Mobius transformation is linear transformation, as its degree is 1. Fine. Such that this equation represents a circle in such a way that f of z 2 will be equal to 1, that is what the definition is, and f of z 3 is equal to 0, and f of z 4 is equal to infinity. That is, these element map to these numbers as I assumed it earlier. So since they are real, I can write f of z 1, f of z 2, f of z 3, f of z 4 lie on z axis. Right, because z1, z3, z2, z4 are lying on circle. So we have already proved in a previous theorem, right? So it either represents circle or it represents line. That is a Mobius transformation. So since all these four points lies on a circle, therefore they lie on a z axis. Meaning is that since z is real, therefore I can write f of z1, f of z2, f of z3, f of z4. Is also real. So if a function is real, elements is also real. That is z1, this implies that z1, z2, z3, z4 is also real. So concept is quite abstract. I'm sorry, I'm helpless. You have to practice, you don't have any way. So anyhow, it is important. So please don't share this material with any one of your friends. Fine. So this is 6 mark question. That is what we require to prove, is 4 points lie in a circle only when this is real. So what I have assumed is all the 4 points lie in a circle. Anyhow, we have already proved that theorem. Now what we have proved is all these points are real. Fine. Hope so it is clear, and the same notes I will forward in the group. Please copy the same. So this completes the first unit. from the next session, I'll start with the second unit. For that, you need the information regarding the series and sequence. So you have already studied the concept of series and sequence in your UG classes. Please go through the basics of series and series. Anyhow, I'll just revise the concept, whatever the needed. You need the concept of Taylor series and Maclaurin series, as you already studied. So on concept of sequence, series, convergence, test for convergence, you have to know everything. Then only you can understand the second unit. Hope so, first unit is clear for you. And now, assignment for you. I have an assignment for you. Assignment is, please collect the questions, a question paper of complex analysis, and solve first unit questions. Solve first unit questions in separate book, and you have to make it PDF format, and please forward the same in a group. Hope so, everybody is seeing the video, that is why I'm telling you. And the last date for submitting it is within the 20th of this month. You have to submit it. If you see this video, then only you can get an assignment. I mean, you can submit the assignment. So your internal marks will be purely based on the assignments and test. So please write on the assignment. I mean, you have to solve whatever the questions there in the first unit. In a question paper, you have to solve the questions. And of course, as I already told you, some of the questions will not be done. Why? Because it is asked from second unit. So after the completion of second unit, you will get answers for all the questions. Anyhow, whatever the answers you have right now, you have to do it in assignment book and make a PDF format and forward it in a complex analysis group. Hope so, you will do it. Thank you. Continue in the next session.